In short track speed skating, there has always been Korea. Introduced as a medal sport in the 1992 Winter Olympics, Kim Ki-hoon of Korea was the first individual gold medalist in this exciting sport. Since then, the Koreans have never looked back. Although American Apollo Anton Ono has stolen the spotlight with an impressive 8 Olympic medals to his credit, it is the Koreans that dominate the sport, having won 37 Olympic medals since its debut, 19 of them gold. In world championship competition, they have captured 146 medals, making South Korea a dynasty in short track speed skating. A system of success is in place in Seoul for South Koreans to continue their tradition of excellence. At ice rinks around the country, national team members share the ice with the general public, giving up-and-coming athletes an up-close and personal look at exactly what it takes to become a champion. In Korea, there are thousands of youngsters with Olympic dreams, and yet only a select few will ever receive the opportunity to represent their country at this level.
Short track is just incredibly competitive in Korea. They even said it's tougher to be a Korean national team than win a gold.
Sung-hoon Lee was one of the favorites to represent Korea at the Olympic Winter Games in Vancouver. Despite adversity and hardship, the dedication to his Olympic dream never faltered.
He began skating when he was an elementary school kid, and when he was like fourth grade or something, his father's business fell down and they couldn't support him. So they want him to quit. He even said, I walk to school to compete 10, 15 miles from his house to school. So his father buy a old car, give him a ride every day.
My parents really sacrificed a lot for me. They knew how much I loved the sport, and they would take me to practice every morning and then after school. If I didn't have my parents' support, I wouldn't be where I am right now.
Sung-hoon was awarded a prestigious government scholarship to the Korea National Sport University in Seoul. Since its establishment in 1977, this university's athletes and alumni have amassed over 100 Olympic medals, 30% of all medals won by Korean athletes in Olympic competition. Sung-hoon Lee was at the top of the class in short track skating and exploded onto the international scene in 2008. At the 2008 World Short Track Speed Skating Championships, Sung-hoon bested the world's elite in the individual 3,000 meter event with a dramatic gold medal performance and was instrumental in South Korea's victory in the 5,000 meter relay. In 2009, his momentum continued as he became the first South Korean to win 3 gold medals at the World University Games, taking home the hardware at distances of 1,000, 1,500, and 3,000 meters. In April of 2009, with the sacrifice and hardships behind him, Sung-hoon entered the South Korean national short track competition with the Olympics well within his grasp. But by the time the competition was over, Lee had failed to make the Olympic team in any discipline. Having failed to make the Olympic team, Sung-hoon Lee's dream of representing South Korea was gone, or was it? Lee had failed to make the Olympic team in any discipline. His dream of representing South Korea in short track had slipped away.
I didn't make the short track team because of mistakes I made. But I couldn't accept this failure. I couldn't let go of my dream of making the Olympic team.
With an incredible display of perseverance and dedication, Sung-hoon Lee makes a radical decision. For the next 9 months, he will dedicate himself to making the Olympic team in long track speed skating. This is an entirely different type of skating and is not unlike an Olympic sprinter deciding to become a distance runner. Johan Koss of Norway is arguably the best long track skater of all time.
I would say that there's a big difference changing from short track to long track. The equipment is very different. The blade is put in a very different position. At short track, there's pack racing and you have to be in first two spots to qualify for the next round. You have one race in long track, that's it. You had to make it all happen tactically and strategically. Those two events are very different.
I put on my speed skates at the rink last year and I had a good feeling things would work out. People around me said I would not even be able to make the Olympic team, but I was not satisfied.
Well, when we heard that he was going to make that change, we were going like, wow, I don't think that will make much of a difference. But then he quickly had good results in the World Cup.
I didn't really change areas, but I speed skated as I would do short track. Just like Korea is number one in short track, I trained the same way for speed skating. And I think the hard training paid off at the end towards success. But throughout the course of my training, I trained with the best athletes in Korea. I slowly gained confidence and became a national champion.
I knew he was good because he had had a couple of good races in the World Cup, maybe 6th to 8th place. Just before the Olympics, I didn't really expect Sung-hoon Lee to be in the top three. The 5,000 meter, he got silver medal, which was incredible. Looking at that, we obviously realized that he was going to do well in the 10,000. And actually, during the Olympics, watching him train for the 10,000, I thought he was from somewhere else because I never seen anybody train that hard on the ice leading up to a competition.
The 10,000-meter event took place 10 days after Sung-hoon's historic silver medal performance. Prior to the Olympics, he had run a full 10,000-meter course only twice. But on this day, in this venue, he rose to the occasion and set a new Olympic record with the fastest time ever.
Before getting the gold medal, I thought it was the greatest thing ever. But the moment I got it, I thought, is this medal the reason I've put so much effort into this? And also thought that I should really strive toward a higher goal. People suggest I go for the medal in both areas.
In a classic display of Korean fortitude, Sung-hoon Lee not only stayed true to his dream, his willingness to make the kinds of sacrifices necessary to compete in long track revealed another classic example of the Korean character, a willingness to draw valuable lessons from the past before letting go to create a better future. Golf's great moments on the LPGA with Seri Pak and the PGA with Y.E. Yang.